Miss Internet, chairlady of the Barbuda Council. Where to begin, where to start? This is just one word, epic. What we experienced is like something you see in a horror movie. It's something that you watch on TV, but not something you expect to actually happen in reality. I mean, persons were literally running from house to house, and we had cars flying over our heads. We had containers, 40-foot containers, flying left and right. And the story that you're getting from most of the residents here is that the eye of the storm came just in time. Persons were literally tying themselves to their roofs with ropes to keep them down, holding on.
It has been surreal devastation on the sister isle. This has been the result of Hurricane Irma's fury, a powerful Atlantic storm, one of the most powerful on record, 185-mile-per-hour winds crashing into the sister isle. That has been the result. So, Prime Minister, let's unpack what happened, the immensity of the destruction in Barbuda. So, what happened to the residents while all of this happened? Where were they when all this destruction happened?
Well, they were in their homes, and they took the necessary precautions. In fact, I was speaking to the chairlady of the Barbuda Council up until about 1:30 a.m. this morning. And up to that point, she had indicated that all was well. A little late in the morning, I was told that residents had actually communicated that a few roofs were lost. But when you're on the ground and certainly in the dark of night, it would have been difficult for them to give an accurate assessment to the extent of the damage. So we were of the view here that perhaps the damage would have been limited, not recognizing, having done the aerial view, that the entire housing stock was damaged. And we have to raise a significant amount of resources now to rebuild Barbuda and to restore it to normalcy. The good thing about it is that we had already made some contingency plans. I have to admit that at one point we thought that they may not have been necessary. We did not cancel them. We have actually delayed some of them because we weren't too sure of the extent of the damage in Barbuda. It means now that we will activate those mechanisms. So tomorrow we have about two cargo planes full of supplies that will be landing here in Antigua. We had asked the Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela to assist us in providing two cargo planes, two military planes to move some building material probably out of Panama. So we will now pursue those options and to make sure that we can move building material into Barbuda as quickly as possible to start the rebuilding process.